This device is shown because it is available on loan to agencies and contractors through the FHWA's Mobile Concrete Technology Center. The Super Air Meter, or SAM, is a simple field-friendly device that measures the air void system of concrete. It does this by testing plastic concrete as opposed to the traditional method of measuring the air void system in hardened concrete. This video covers the operational aspects of the device only, not the scientific details of how the device works. For this demonstration, we are using the SAM inside our mobile lab, but, like the Type B pressure pot, the device is durable enough to be used on grade. To do the calibration process, you will need to fill a clean SAM device with water. Attach the top of the device and the funnel, then fill it with water. Close the opposing petcock. Now, hold and release the menu button of the digital gauge to abort the current process. Once abort stops flashing, hold and release the menu button. Use the menu and zero buttons to cycle to calibration and press enter. Next, just run this portion like a standard pressure test and follow the gauge instructions. Pressurize it to roughly 1 psi above 14.5, let it stabilize, then adjust it to within plus or minus 0.05 of 14.5 psi. Detach the funnel and close the second petcock and press enter on the gauge. Follow the on-screen instructions by holding the lever and pressing enter. Continue to hold the lever until after the countdown when the gauge shows OK. You will then repeat these steps, pressurizing the device first to 30 psi, then to 45 psi. The gauge will instruct you to do so as well. Pressurize to 30 psi, hold and press enter, then do the same for 45 psi. Follow the gauge's instructions. Release the pressure from the air pot by opening the petcocks, then from the upper chamber by opening the pressure valve. Remove the device lid and insert the calibration vessel, which conforms to ASTM C231 Section 4.4, which adds 5% air by volume. Reattach the device lid, then the funnel. Fill the device with water, but do not burp the device with the calibration vessel inside. Then, close the petcock opposite the funnel. Detach the funnel and close the second petcock. Close the pressure valve and pressurize the device to 14.5 psi. Following the gauge's instructions, hold the lever, wait for the bubbling sound to stop, then press enter. Do not hit the device with a mallet when the calibration vessel is inside. Continue to hold the lever until the gauge says OK. The device will ask if you want to save the calibration. Press enter to save. Release the pressure from the lower air pot by opening the petcocks, then from the upper chamber by opening the pressure valve. Remove the device's lid, then remove the calibration vessel and shake it out. Insert the calibration vessel back into the device, then reattach the lid and funnel. Refill the device with water without burping the device, then close the petcock opposite the funnel. Now, the device will have automatically turned off. Press and hold enter to turn on the device. Press and hold the menu button to abort, then press and hold the menu button to reach the menu. Cycle to test and press enter. Cycle to type B and press enter again. Detach the funnel, close the second petcock and pressure valve, then pressurize the device to 14.5 psi. Follow the device's instructions and hold the lever. Wait for the bubbling sound to end, then press enter. Continue to hold the lever until the gauge says OK. Then press enter to view the air content. The number should be within plus or minus 0.2 of 5.0. To obtain a concrete sample, follow ASTM C172 or ASHTO R60. The method of filling the device's air pot is identical to that of the Type B meter. First, make sure to wet down the air pot as well as any tools to be used. Fill it in three equal layers, each one about one-third of the pot's volume. Rod each layer 25 times, then strike the sides of the container 10 to 15 times per layer. Next, strike off the top with a strike-off plate. Finally, clean off the pot and the rim. This step is crucial with this device. It pressurizes the pot to significantly higher levels than a Type B pot, so even a small grain of sand can cause a pressure leak. Clean and wet the rim and gasket of the upper section of the device. Place the upper chamber onto the air pot and clamp it down by securing clamps on opposing sides simultaneously. Turn on the device by squeezing and holding the enter button. It is important to squeeze the gauge rather than simply pressing the button, as the gauge can break off with repeated stress. Then, press and hold the menu button to abort any previous test. Press and hold the menu button again to access the menu, cycle to test using the menu and zero buttons, and press enter. Now cycle to SAM and press enter again. Ensure both petcocks are open and attach the funnel to one or the other. Fill the device with water until a steady stream is flowing out of the petcock. Next, burp the device by slowly tilting the meter towards the funnel until the opposing petcock's opening is horizontal. Close both petcocks and unscrew the funnel. The device's screen should be instructing you to pressurize to 14.5 psi. Make sure the pressure valve is closed, but don't over-tighten. Now, pump up the pressure to roughly 1 psi above 14.5, as the pressure falls slightly in stabilization when you stop pumping. Use the pressure valve and pump to get the pressure within plus or minus 0.05 psi of 14.5 psi. Just barely open the pressure valve when you do, because the pressure will quickly bleed out of it otherwise. Once the pressure is stabilized and within 0.05 psi, press enter. The device should say reading, then OK. After that, it will tell you to hold the lever, hit the air pot, then press enter. Do so in that order, and be careful to avoid hitting the clamps when you hit the air pot with the mallet. Continue to hold the lever through the 10-second countdown, as well as through the screen showing read. Release the lever when the screen shows OK. At this point, the gauge will instruct you to press enter to view air. This will be your air content from the Type B meter method. You will then repeat these steps, pressurizing the device first to 30 psi, then to 45 psi. The gauge will instruct you to do so as well. Pressurize to 30 psi, hold, hit, and press enter, then do the same for 45 psi. After the device completes its 45 psi reading, you will need to do the entire process over again. First, open the petcocks while covering them with your hands. Then slowly release the pressure from the upper chamber. Next, attach the funnel, refill with water, including the burping, then close the petcocks and detach the funnel. Now, after pressing enter on the gauge, you will repeat the pressure steps for 14.5, 30, and 45 psi. Pump the device to roughly 1 psi above, let it stabilize, adjust it to within plus or minus 0.05 psi, hold the lever, hit the side with a mallet, press enter, then continue holding until the gauge says OK. Do this again for 30 and 45 psi. Finally, the gauge will instruct you to press enter to view both the total air content and the SAM number. Now you have completed the SAM test. You may have noticed how we keep the clamps up by using a large rubber band. This makes running the air test easier, as well as storing the device. When you clamp down the lid, do so on opposing sides simultaneously. Every time you press a button on the device's gauge, you need to support the back of it, as if you were squeezing it. This is to prevent the gauge from breaking off due to repeated stress. Avoid the clamps when you strike the device with a mallet. Hitting them will result in an invalid test, as well as potentially damaging the clamp. When pressurizing the device, getting it within plus or minus 0.01 to 0.03 psi is preferred over 0.05 psi. Wherever you plan on using the device, let it acclimate to the ambient temperature. For instance, if you plan on using it outside on a warm day, don't let it sit in an air-conditioned vehicle before use. Don't leave the device in the sun, as this could damage the digital gauge and make it unreadable. When storing, make sure that the device is completely dry. Moisture can allow mildew to grow, as well as potentially fouling the gauge. When you close the device's case, ensure that the gauge and clamps are securely placed and do not get crushed by the lid. This is where the rubber band comes in handy. If you have to run multiple tests in one day, the CAPE is a helpful tool. It essentially compresses the upper chamber of the SAM to near 14.5, 30, or 45 psi, depending on the hose you use. For more videos of other concrete materials and construction-related technologies, visit our website.